And he shows us a principle. God's always doing something new. This is his character. It's his nature. Get used to it. Buy into it. Stop fighting it, right? Stop getting left behind. God's doing something new, and he wants you to go with him. Two, if he's doing something new, he's going to give you the provision you need to do that new thing. Many times when you're going into a new year, people are either excited about it or they've kind of been challenged in the last year and they're like, man, I hope this year is not like that one. Either way, there's a proper way to enter the new year and there's an improper way to enter the new year. And today we're going to talk about that. But one of the things that I see is that a lot of times people do one of two things. Mm-hmm. They have a great year, right? They have a really great year, and then they go into the next year, and then they get lax. They relax too much. They're like, it was so great last year, I can relax. And then they end up having a bad year because they didn't keep pressing in their faith.
Yeah.
They didn't keep in patience with their faith and the works that follow faith. And so they actually end up with a year that's not what it should be. And watch this, they lose momentum. Mm-hmm. So they were gaining momentum and then they take a dip and lose momentum. And then the other side of that coin is that people had some challenges in the year before or at the end of the year. This is kind of what happened here. You could feel it. People were really challenged in the month of December. People were challenged spiritually. I think a lot of people didn't realize it was a spiritual attack.
Yeah.
And so they didn't handle it exactly right. And you could tell that they were feeling kind of beat down and worn down and weighed down. And we just preached right through it. And we got the victory by preaching through it. I think we really had a big breakthrough this Sunday. But a lot of times people will lose their expectation mm-hmm. and they will not carry that into the new year. So even if it's a good year, it starts slow,
yeah.
right? And it shouldn't be that way. There's a way to go into the new year. There's a way to go into anything new. There's a way to go into pretty much every new day
yeah.
with God. And that's the way we're supposed to be. We're supposed to be this way all the time. And that is in great love, great hope,
yes.
joyful, confident expectation, and a great faith. And that should never leave us, right? He says, rejoice always, right? Mm-hmm. So that means every day should be filled with rejoicing. But you and I both know that that's not how you feel all the time. You don't always feel like rejoicing. You don't always feel like doing those things. And that's where you have to learn a new habit. You
yeah.
have to learn a new biblical habit of looking forward to the promise of God
yeah.
all the time. Because every day is new to him. And I want to look at this verse. And if you would, look at Isaiah 43:19.
Yes, sir.
Isaiah 43:19. I really hope that's the right verse.
Me too.
If not, I'll be stopping you. Let's see. Yep, that's it. That's it.
Behold, I will do something new.
Yes.
Now it will spring forth. Will you not be aware of it?
Yes.
I will even make a roadway in the wilderness, rivers in the desert.
Amen. So if you know anything about the book of Isaiah, you know that when it hits about chapter 40, he stops talking about the old covenant people of God, and he mm-hmm. starts talking about the new covenant people of God, which you and I are. If you're born again, he's talking about you. And I want you to see this because this new thing that God's doing, that's who he is.
Yeah.
If you don't move forward with God, you are going backwards because he will be leaving you doing his new things. In other words, faith and expectation grabs a hold of the coattails of God and holds on for dear life. I mean, God's moving forward, and if you're not diligent to stay there, you'll get left behind for a few minutes. Praise God for his mercy to help us catch up. But he's doing a new thing, and we see that in the ministry. Literally, we are working on some major new stuff this year, as if we didn't have enough last year. And we're already working on some major new things this year.
Yes.
And, correct, yeah. And so there's a lot of new things happening, but we've found that we're just taking after our dad. Mm-hmm. You know, we're just taking after our father. But if you don't have the right heart and the right mindset, right, then you will get left behind. You will feel inadequate, right? But one of the things that you see is that a lot of times when we go into something new, now, and watch this, I want you to see this. This is something the world taught you in corruption. God didn't teach you this.
Right.
God didn't teach you this. This is not biblical. This is not a way of God. This is something the world taught us, and we have to recognize that and deal with it. For example, I'll give you this, and then I'll explain it. When I say, hey, it's time to do a fast, most people in the world, and especially in America, go, oh, I don't want to do a fast, right? And they look at, watch, the price that they will have to pay,
yep,
instead of the seed that God will put in their hand to pay that price.
Yeah.
So they look at it coming out of themselves instead of coming out of heaven, the price, the grace that they need. Even with fasting, like I get so excited about fasting now. I literally look forward to it. That was not always the case, but I had to renew my mind. And now when I look forward to it, it's easy.
Yes.
Like it's literally easy and light because I've changed my faith and hope on it. I've changed my expectation on it based on the promises of God. So if God, if his character and nature is to always do a new thing, and notice that that verse says, I will do a new thing. Now
yes,
it's coming to you. Now it's coming to you. Not in the future. Now he's doing a new thing. So if you'll get that faith and expectation that God's going to do a new thing now, and he's going to pay for it. Not me. The price that I pay is the choice to believe for him to do it.
Yes.
And to be obedient to what he tells me to do. In other words, if I will learn how to set my heart and purpose my heart, God will give me the supernatural seed of his supernatural grace to make happen the things that I can't do on my own.
Yeah.
Jesus says it in Mark 10. He says, look, listen, these things for you to do alone, they're impossible. But with God, all things are possible. And he shows us a principle. God's always doing something new. This is his character. It's his nature. Get used to it. Buy into it. Stop fighting it, right? Stop getting left behind. God's doing something new, and he wants you to go with him. Two, if he's doing something new, he's going to give you the provision you need to do that new thing.
Amen.
Say it right now. Say, Lord, right now, I receive the provision to do that new thing, right? And that's the mindset we have to have. So a lot of times when you hear about doing something new or adding something to your plate, instantly a corrupted worldly thinking mind with a mindset on the world and its corruption and lack will go, oh, no. But a mindset on Christ will go, oh, how are you going to do that? This is literally the difference between John the Baptist's dad, who was actually had to have his mouth shut up so he wouldn't talk the promise away, versus Mary, the mother of Jesus, because their heart was different. One said, oh, how's that going to happen? Like, I don't know how that's going to happen. This is going to stink, you know? But then Mary's like, how is that going to happen? And the change in the difference in their hope and their faith brought about a promise,
yeah,
in a totally different way.
Yeah.
And that's where we should be all the time.
Yeah. Well, I brought this topic up a couple days ago because honestly, you were talking about December having opportunities in it. For me personally, December was one of the most opportunistic spiritual attacks I'd had mentally to stay in a place of joy, to stay in a place of expectation. There were so many opportunities literally in that last month, relationally with other people,
yeah,
that when Christmas week happened, it was like I was trying to take a deep sigh and I couldn't,
right,
for lack of just as a word picture on it.
Yeah.
So we got to the day of needing to come back to work and start things up. And praise God for a shepherd. But I had reached out to Pastor Nicole and I told her, I'm like, look, I can sense that like the spirit of dread and fear is trying to come on me to go back and start something I love. I yeah. love the ministry. Yeah. Like anyone who knows me knows I love the ministry. I love the Lord. I'm thrilled to be, this is my dream.
Yeah.
But I could sense an attack of fear trying to be there of,
yeah.
I don't want it to be like it was last year.
Yes.
I don't want to repeat the same things yeah. that we were facing. I want this to be different and X, Y, Z. And I'm so thankful for her because in one message, the anointing was released and she said something so simple and she was like, Barrett, you can't think like that.
That's right.
Like you can't do it.
Yeah.
And just that phrase of you can't do that woke me up to see it that day.
Yeah.
Oh, this is an attack.
Correct.
But I also saw through that whole day, it was not just on me. It
Correct.
Tried to come on a bunch of the staff.
Correct.
It tried to come on the people in the church that I saw.
Yeah.
I was like, we're not going to repeat 2023's errors.
Yeah.
We'll repeat the victories and grow. But I want to hear from you. How do we ensure that anything that wasn't him, we're done with it.
Yeah.
And we step into that place where we can't go back
yeah.
to there.
Yeah. Well, one of the things is she really hit on something that's very important. And, you know, she and I both had that same conversation about ourselves. Like, you can't think like that,
mm-hmm.
you know. But one of the things is getting that through your head that this is... I should say illegal
yes.
for me to think like that. Like I can't just know that it's not right. I've got to make it so that thinking like that offends me, mm-hmm. right? It offends me. Literally, I've gotten to the point where when people think like that, when they have an I can't attitude, I will call it in a split second mm-hmm. if I notice it. And it aggravates me. But the reason it aggravates me is because when I lived with that I can't attitude, it held me back. And I don't want them held back.
Yeah.
And I don't want them holding anything else back either. But it literally aggravates me now because it's become, in my mindset, that's illegal.
Yeah.
That is not allowed. That is straight from the pits of hell. Any thinking on things that's not worthy of praise is straight from the pits of hell because he tells us how to think. He
mm-hmm.
he says, think on things worthy of praise. So anything that's not worthy of praise in that way, that is illegal to God's command. And I should see it as such.
Yeah.
Stop allowing that to be an option in my thinking. And so now it offends me. It offends my spirit when that type of thinking comes up. When you don't allow yourself to think any other way, you're taking those thoughts captive. You're actually winning a spiritual battle right there. And you're staying in the flow with God and then the flow with His grace instead of opposing it.
Yes.
If you start thinking it's going to be hard, it might not work. That's entering into a comparison of a holy thing, a supernatural thing that God said, and a common thing of logic and worldly lack.
Yeah.
You're bringing the Word of God, this supernatural, blessed, holy thing, down to an unholy thought process. Totally wrong. Totally, almost blasphemous. It really is.
Yeah.
People don't realize that, but it really is almost blasphemous to compare. Like to me, it feels like that. It feels
yeah.
on that level, like you can't do that. That's why she said that. You've got to get it through your thinking that to think that it won't work when God said to do it is like blasphemy
yeah.
against him. It's a blasphemous, it's heresy because you're saying that God won't do what he says. You are contradicting his character and nature to even think those thoughts.
Yeah.
And so when you get a hold of that and then those thoughts come, all of a sudden you're like, I can't think that. Mm-hmm. And that's where that came from. See, that came out of her spirit.
Mm-hmm.
That's something she has renewed her mind to, and now her spirit, because her mind's renewed and not blocking what the spirit's saying, that flowed out of her spirit and hit you with an anointing to help break that off of you.
Yes.
So the reason why she was able to help you is because she's renewed her mind. We've renewed our mind to that. We don't think that way, right? And so we don't allow ourselves to think that way, and you shouldn't either. No believer should. Mm-hmm. It's actually, you know, a complete contradiction to God's character. And so then when that thought tries to tempt you, mm-hmm. but you've renewed your mind to it, that same flow out of the Spirit will rise up and smack that thing and cast it down, and it's much easier.
Yeah.
But you've got to renew your mind to it. You can't keep thinking, well, maybe it'll work, maybe it won't. You think like that, it's going to be a long, hard road. If you actually believe God, it'll be light and easy. It's already been done and paid for, right? Even where, like Jesus, you know, you'll hear sometimes like there's no more work left to be done. But there is still some work happening in this way because he tells us Jesus is interceding for us. So he is doing something right now. He's interceding for us. But I want you to see, on what basis does he have to intercede for us? On the finished work at the cross.
Yeah.
So, in other words, he's just praying out what's already authorized. He's just praying out in heaven, interceding for us, what's authorized, right, by the work of the cross, the finished work of the cross and the resurrection, proving that in when he came up from the grave. So, he's literally saying, you should not be doubting anything. Because I've already finished everything that could hold you back. It's the wages of sin that's death. Right? Not walking with God that's death. Walking with God is life to the full till it overflows, right? He's telling us those things so that we can walk in them. So anytime we see lack try to come up, the will of God on earth as it is in heaven, there's no lack in heaven. Anytime we see lack come up, we got to not only know that it's going to be okay, we got to go to the place where we receive the okay now, right? And we don't consider any other thing. What do we consider? Not our body, not our finances, not any of that. We consider Jesus, we consider Christ, the anointed one and his anointing that broke every yoke, finished the work, paid for it. And so what we consider is this is already done.
Yeah.
It's done. It's done. It's done.
Amen.
Like it's already done. It's done. It was done on the cross. Lord, we receive that provision now. Right now, for every person that's believing God for your own provision, for your business provision, for provision to sow, whatever it is, right now in the name of Jesus, provision be, and we receive it now because it's done. It was done 2,000 years ago, and because it was done and handled, we have a right to provision. He's Jehovah Jireh, the Lord who provides. We have a right to him. We have a right. Jesus says, I'll disclose all things. I'll take everything that the Father has. It's mine, and I give it to you. I give it to you. Lord, we have your provision. It's done now. Thank you, Lord. We have it now. Right now in personal finances, bills, business finances, bills, debt, we have it now in the name of Jesus. Health in your body. Right now, help. That provision, that work is done. The finished work of Christ is done. We don't consider what the doctor says. We consider what Jesus did about it. It's already done. We have it now in Jesus' name. Glory to God.
Amen.
We have the provision of protection now in the name of Jesus. We receive it. We have it now. We have the restoration. Some of you hearing this, you need restoration. We have restoration now by the finished work of Christ. We consider not what we've gone through. Stop considering what you've gone through negatively.
Mm-hmm.
Stop considering where you came from negatively. Consider where you're going in the finished work of Christ. Starting when? Now.
Mm-hmm.
Now. we're going, he's restored you. He's not just restoring you. He has restored you, right? He has protected you. He has delivered you. Stop looking forward to things with negativity and a lack of praise. That's a heresy. It is a heresy against the character and nature of God. He said, I'm not withholding any good thing to those who walk uprightly. All we have to do is make a choice and then follow it. I'm going to walk uprightly. I'm going to be a person of faith. I'm going to be a person of hope. And you're going to have those things not withheld, but actually manifested to you through the finished work of Christ.
Yeah.
Go to Isaiah 43:19 again,
yes,
and read it slowly.
Yes,
hear
sir.
This word again. This is the character and nature of God. This is the will of God. It's a part of who he is. And he's not made you to not be able to handle it. You are designed to handle this. You are designed to not just walk and get through. You are designed to thrive.
Yeah.
Read it.
Behold, I will do something new.
Yes.
Now it will spring forth. Will you not be aware of it? I will even make a roadway in the wilderness, rivers in the desert.
See, when he's asking that question, will you not be aware of it?
Mm-hmm.
Will you not realize, will you let the negative thoughts of the world take you away from what I actually want to do? I'm telling you,
yeah,
there's something there, and I want you to not be unaware of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Will you not be aware of what I'm doing, the
yeah,
new things I want to do in your life? I'm going to do them now.
Yes.
That's how you enter the new year. You get your faith on that.
The verse right before it literally says, do not call to mind the former things.
Yeah.
Don't ponder on things of the past. Then behold. So literally, I mean, you just basically
it tells you
it.
What to do. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is where we're supposed to live. Understand, that's not just for the new year. That's the new you.
Mm-hmm.
Hear that? It's not just the new year. That's the new you. That's how you think from this day forward.
Yeah.
That's biblical, godly thinking. And that's what takes away that pressure. That's what takes away that pain. And, you know, people see that all the time. They're like, how do you keep going with it? Because here's what people don't realize. Like, here's the thing that people don't realize is, think about this. How many people have you had coming to you and saying negative stuff? You said at the end you recognized it was not just on you but other people, right? How did that, as a leader, how did that make you feel?
It had the temptation to be discouraging.
Yeah, because one, they should be lifting you up, and you should be lifting them up. You both should be doing that to each other. If they're not doing it, they're dull and drab when they should be coming up. It's discouraging to you for them.
And then frustrating because you want to fix it for them.
Correct. Now multiply that times about what you see times about five. For me. So, and now watch this. Not only do I handle theirs, and understand I'm not doing this on my own. I'm doing this through faith and trust and belief in God,
mm-hmm,
right? In his faithfulness. But understand that actually multiplied times five, all those people with the negative and all the problems, and you know, I can't solve all of them by myself. I'm not supposed to. I'm not their source. God is.
Yeah.
Right? But and I keep myself up, and I pull them up out of there, too.
Yeah.
So understand the strength that takes to do that. That's the strength that a leader needs to carry. Now watch this. Watch. But it's not me doing it. It's just me believing in God and trusting and having faith towards God. He's doing it. He's doing the work. But I want you to see the difference in staying at that place, continuing to go forward with passion, with all the people pulling down on in that way. If I can do that with myself and all those other negative pulls at certain times, especially if there's an attack or something, if I can do that by God, see, understand, through the power of God, what can you do for yourself?
Right.
What can you do when you choose to just believe for yourself? Well, then you choose to believe for yourself and you stop being the pull, you start being the lifter. Right? And this is where we're supposed to live. So if I can do that for myself and the whole ministry, then you definitely can do that. See how easy that can be.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not saying that it has been, but see how easy it can be for you to just be able to handle yourself.
Yes.
But God will take you beyond that. You'll be able to carry people with you too.
Amen.
Make disciples. This is the plan of God. And so think about that. Think about if everybody in the church that's here now, and let's say we added, 10 times more people. But think about it. If everybody that's in the church now upheld themselves and drew up other people the same way I'm doing it right now,
yeah.
What would this church be?
Totally different.
What would this church be? what would it be? Because you don't see churches like that.
Yeah.
You don't see people that take the responsibility to do that.
Yeah.
You see people letting that responsibility fall on the pastor and telling them good luck. But what if believers chose to believe?
Yeah.
And they not only lifted themselves up, but they lifted up other people. Because that's not, I have a grace to pastor, but that's not just the grace to pastor. That's the grace from believing.
Right.
From being a child of God. You see?
Yes, sir.
So you have that ability as well. You have that ability. The ability to pastor is talking about having a grace to help people get out of those things, not help carry them alone,
yeah.
Right? It's not just that. It's giving them wisdom to help people navigate out of it, right? Not just mm-hmm. hold them up. That grace to hold them up, that's what every believer has on them, to hold themselves up. And because, why? How do I know this? Because every believer is called to make disciples. Disciple makers are literally picking people up until they can hold themselves up.
Yeah.
That's what a disciple maker is. And he's called every believer to do that. So that's not just a pastoral gift. Right?
Yes, sir.
You see that? It goes along with it, and it helps, but that's not just a pastoral gift. So, amen.
Amen.
Did you get something out of this? Did you get something out of it? It's good. This is how you go into a new year. Thinking on things worthy of praise, beholding God's doing something new. Stop thinking about things of the past. He's doing something new now.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name. Father, right now, let that new thing come to pass in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. That is coming to pass now, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God. Get ready. Get your expectation up. Enter into this year the proper way. God's got this. You've got this with God. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to worry about a new thing. You don't have to worry about new things on your plate. You don't have to worry about juggling them. The grace of God's going to help you when you go into love and hope and faith. Those things will abide and they will stand. Are you ready to go and take off from the launch pad very quickly, leaving all of that lack behind you? Thank you so much for joining with us on What's the Word today. We're so glad to have you. And we believe that the seed of the Word is found the fertile soil of your heart and is producing in you the eternal fruit, taking you to the next level in Jesus Christ. You can go to our website, whatsright.com. And if this full teaching is available, there's that and many other series and resources that can help you live an abundant life in God. We sow this broadcast into the world, and if you would like to be a part of that, if you'd like to partner with us or give one time, you don't have to, but you're welcome to, also at whatsright.com. We invite you also every day. We broadcast every weekday live at noon Eastern Standard Time. You can also find that on the website. If you're done with average and you are done with mediocrity, these are the things that we are teaching about all the time. You found a place that will help hold you by the hand and lift you up to these new places in Christ. We look forward to seeing you there. Join with us. Connect with us. We'll see you again on What's the Word. We love you. Have a great day.